Welcome back to Worlds 2021. It is neck and neck between T1 and Damwon Kia. High stakes heading into game three to find out who will be at match point. And naturally, our attention turns back to the draft. No surprise to see Damwon Kia elect to be on the blue side after their loss in game two. But so much is being defined right now by the pick ban phase.
Oh yeah, definitely is. There's so many interesting picks coming out. I mean, Koma versus Faker, he's really pushing them in the draft with the Maokais, but then them responding with things like the Yasuo. I think blue side is looking very strong, and it just basically dictates how the rest of the draft plays out.
I mean, the rising of priority of Jhin, of Lee Sin, you know, both of these games, it feels like those could become more contested picks. And it does make you wonder, are you willing to drop a ban, right? You know, are you willing to actually ban out this Lee Sin, drop one of the bans on red side, and potentially give something over there? Do you have a plan, you know, prepared for if you were to give over a TF or something along those lines? Because the Lee Sin has been such a problem for both teams for these two games.
Definitely has, and alongside the Jhin, it feels like picks are just so easy to make. The LeBlanc coming out from Shieldmaker responded by the Lissandra of Faker. And here we go straight into draft. Damwon on blue side. You expect T1's red side bans just have to be things like Yuumi and now Lee Sin if they adapt rather than playing the Poppy. They could run back the Poppy into Lee Sin, but I think it's just better to ban that away, ban away the TF as well, and
like
let the Syndra go through. You can respond to the Syndra with a control mage, and you can respond to LeBlanc with the Syndra. So I think you just kind of cover all your bases by banning away these champions.
And both junglers just look so much better when they were playing aggressive, when they were the ones that are able to initiate plays. You just can't really do that on Poppy in the same way. So TF, Lee Sin, Yuumi, the red side bans here. Graves will be banned out. J4 is up. I don't know that they would really first pick this, but wow, they will. So they're really highly prioritizing the aggressive early jungle. This was actually banned out by T1 last time when they got the Lee Sin, but it was, you know, a second round ban, and they just want to deny the ability to make these early plays, make these early visits to the lane.
I worry for them, though. If T1 go for things like LeBlanc on three, unless Damwon want to take that away, they can draft into a lot of mobility here. They could opt into things like the Jace. We saw them go Jace Ryze on 1-2 here, but into Jarvan, it seems a little bit risky. Maybe we see owner's Qiyana into Jarvan, of course. Could be a good matchup. And there's the Jhin, as we expected.
And it feels like J4 may be soft trying to deny the Jhin by saying, hey, if you pick an immobile carry, we will shut you down in these teamfights. We will leap into that backline and you'll have no path out. Despite that, though, Gumushi again picking up the Jhin. And it has been very strong. And not only has it been strong in his hands, it's been strong in Ghost's hands, simultaneously securing a powerful pick in the context of the series and taking away comfort for Ghost.
Yeah, the ability to follow up on a lot of these fights, these really kind of extended skirmishes where people are diving into the backline, you have the Jhin to follow it up. It is going to be two champions very vulnerable to J4. The Ryze as well as the Jhin can be picked on, and you do have to worry about things like the LeBlanc into this now setting up actually for that J4. You land a chain, you have the flag and drag coming through. Instead, it's going to be the Syndra, which feels, you know, just as good, if not better.
Yeah, it feels like Damwon again have so much range. Jarvan MF ults with a Syndra. I feel like the Ryze won't be able to get in range as much of the time, but we'll see what Faker can do with it over side lanes, expecting T1 to pick up their jungler here, unless they want to opt into a top laner and ban out two to have some kind of priority in the draft.
Definitely the debate. Taking their time on this final pick before they head into the second phase. You can see Faker speaking with a lot of confidence here. It looks like they are just going to try to match jungle, picking up the Xin Zhao, knowing that that pool could get pinched if they did not opt to pick it there.
This is really interesting. You know, I do wonder if T1 will go back towards kind of more similarly what they did in game one, where they did play towards things like the Jace, try to play for 1-3-1, or if they're going to look more for 1-4, try to draft a team fighter, something along the lines of even that Kennen could be pretty strong, but then there's always the possibility of J4 getting flexed towards top, you know, matching that with the Ahri.
Yes, support bans coming out, things like Thresh are up and available. Braum could be a very big pick for T1 to kind of negate the MF ult, but then again, Jhin, Braum, not the best of lane phases, and that's something you'd have to last pick. You can't just blind pick Braum into an MF lane because they can just play a range support, right? So then you're blind picking top lane, which is maybe what you not want to do as T1. So we'll see if they ban away things in the support role, like Enchanters perhaps, if they do want to early rotate things like the Braum.
Quinn also going to be the ban away here, trying to limit the AP top side options. Wouldn't be surprised to see a Kennen follow, kind of the standard two bans you use when you're trying to limit AP top lane picks overall. Past that, you really have to dig deep if you want to find an AP top laner.
Banning out the Jace. We are expecting probably Kennen to be the ban here.
Yep.
And, you know, just trying to deny that from Khan.
So that does leave open the Kennen. And with the Jace ban, that does kind of spell a Kennen pick, unless they want to go towards Gnar. So, yeah.
I wonder if Damwon are willing to flex the J4, you know, flex towards top, because that's a matchup that a lot of people have actually been pretty happy to play.
Ooh, or go for the Aurelia. Play Syndra, Jarvan, mid jungle into the Ryze. It's a mobile, really good setup once again, similarly to LeBlanc, Lee Sin. And then just go for the counter pick in top. Camille, Aurelia are the two champions that stand out to me to be picked up and towards this top side. We know Camille was such a huge priority for Damwon in the finals where they were first picking it, but we might see Barrels Maokai once again. And we talked about the blind pick top for T1. Maybe Braum last pick here could be a big pick for them.
Really taking the time. We'll lock in the Maokai in the end, of course. You can see why it's strong to Leona. Leona banned away. It seems like they're just generally happy with the utility that it was bringing to the table. Does make it that much harder for Kana to find a flank if there is a Maokai threatening with that ultimate to limit his ability to engage.
And Damwon just taking the maximum time. They're not sure what they want to play on that top side. So you wait till the very last second, you lock in your support. You're just trying to give Khan and the rest of the squad even more time to talk this through. Will it in fact be that Lucian?
Looks like it will be the Lucian top once again for Khan. He was struggling last time around because T1 was playing heavy towards the top side. But this support pick will dictate where T1 is playing. Maybe you want to use topside as more of a cover and then let the Jhin lane be where you focus. We know Carrier plays Echo support and Ivia support, Sylas support. I don't think he's going to pick it up in this game against Maokai, but he's just hovering it to show that he can play those things.
I'm waiting, Cadril, because I'm never certain here.
Ooh. I actually really like this. Zillion is a pick that I've been kind of wondering when it will come out, because you can kind of outbreed people with their support picks. If you don't think that you can punish, it is a very weak laning phase, but it pairs incredibly well with champions like Zinn, with champions like Kennen, the speed up, the bomb, the revive. You throw these people into the back line, but it is something that has such a poor early laning phase. You have to get through those early levels, but I think it's potentially the best scaling support in the game.
Who would have thought coming into this match up, the support picks would be Maokai into Zillion. This is awesome. I love this. Zillion is so good into their comp. Jarvan, Syndra, MF, full committing onto an immobile AD carry or Ryze. You pop the ult on him. You give Kennen some move speed. Zillion can get the push in this lane with just double bombing the wave or just poking from range, right? Double range champs into Maokai. These drafts are so creative from both sides. I love to see it.
Incredibly exciting, honestly, draft heading into game three. My only concern is Zillion, if he doesn't get punished, Kennen we've seen, even if you put him down, everyone builds full AP, screws Zhonya's, we're not about that life, and always it'll
Zillion
be
is the Zhonya's.
Zillion is the Zhonya's, that's all you need. And at the end of the day, if you don't have an exhaust ready for that Kennen has been such a tournament-defining pick.
I actually feel like there's a tremendous amount of pressure on Damwon to get something done early in this game. I do think that you have to play with an advantage against this kind of a comp. I think that T1's composition is going to be really hard to beat in the later stages of the game with his support Zillion if he is not punished early.
And Jhin Zillion, so much move speed for that Jhin. He is going to be a rocket ship when he has his fourth shot with the fleet footwork and things like this. So something Damwon have to be careful for, but their composition, just like you said, Azale, is so strong in the early game, right? Lucian, Jarvan, Syndra, they can push in mid, they can set up
Predator
mid.
Again.
Predator for Showmaker in the lane phase. So they're going to go towards top side, and Showmaker will want to move top as much as possible because Faker will have to play safe against Syndra, Jarvan.
And earlier when he was asked by Corizon in an interview what exactly happened with the Predator, he said, I just liked it. He said it like looked at him. They had like an eye-to-eye moment. They said, we're meant for each other.
Oh, my God.
That's going to be a 5v5 level one. There's the bomb. Damwon are going to back off. Okay. My heart skipped a beat there for a second because I thought they were both going to face check each other.
That would have decided the game. But then
that was my We've had slow early games. This was my time to shine, boys. You've been able to talk about meta. I'm like, oh, please, level one.
But Damwon's level one is so much stronger with things like the Lucian, the Maokai, the MF. You can just lock down one target, PTA. And it looks like top lane brush has been the point of contention for both teams to get some early vision for the lane to get the push. Faker's going to ward their blue buff. So T1 have some information to work with in the early game.
This is so interesting. Are they going to try to invade bot side? They delayed the bases so long, and then they're going to go in. And they're hoping potentially, okay, it's just going to be for the ward. And then they will start on that blue buff.
Yeah, it looks like both junglers will be pathing top. Maybe Canyon wants to be creative here. He has got the sweeper. He must know that something is warded on the map, judging by T1's movement around. So maybe he wants to sweep out his Raptors or look for some kind of level 2 gank, perhaps, to force out a flash from the Ryze or bot lane.
Such good information at level 1 coming out from T1. They have a pretty good idea, or we'll be able to track Canyon shortly, assuming he does appear on some vision. Knowing that he's not starting topside, of course, Jarvan level 2 ganks or early ganks in general, always something that can be incredibly lethal. Jarvan has been a very feast or famine champion at this tournament. We saw a lot of early prio at the start of the tournament, not a lot of early results, but a champion that when it gets going is incredibly oppressive.
It's also worth noting,
Carrier.
Oh, one exhaust now coming out, firing back. This is what you talked about, weak early lane phase for Zillion. Level 1, super underwhelming.
I mean, that was just super disrespectful. He like walked through barrel to actually throw the bomb on a ghost. They do have the AD health advantage, but that Q through the minion actually got carry really low. And he's starting a very defensive setup. So it is going to be Guardian. It is going to be Relic Shield. It is going to be Exhaust. But now, no Sums, and you have Flash on Barrel. You just call Kanan down, and it feels like carry is just dead. And that was a pretty significant misposition.
Yeah, the good news for T1, though, is they've had vision on Kanan the whole game. They saw him on Raptors. They just saw him go towards blue. So T1 can afford to step up and push this wave in that's stacking. And they don't have to be scared of getting ganked on it unless Kanan backtracks after Grump and goes towards the bot side of the map. He did just take it, and he's moving towards mid, so fastest level 3 in the game. Red Raptors into Grump, and now he wants to do something with it. Getting Faker's Flash mid early would be disaster for T1 because they have to cover mid the whole game long. Owner's on red. This is a 1v2. Faker needs to be very careful here.
Going towards the middle of the lane. Flag drag, Flash could make it happen. That's going to be the stun. Easy follow. Faker now locked down. He can flash out to safety, but the red buff still ticking. Locked up. Does sidestep the Dark Sphere. Auto attack. Finishes the job. Showmaker finds the kill.
Yeah, it's as simple as that when you're playing Ryzen to Syndra Jarvan. They have so much early game setup, and with no vision around mid, Faker doesn't have anywhere to hug. If he has a ward towards bot side, he can hug bot side. If he has a ward towards top side, he can hug top side. But they only really spot the Jarvan going to Grump, so he should have known this was coming. But he tries to get the cannon and does end up dying. Damwon are going to have so much control through mid right now. Faker will never really be able to push out.
I was expecting him to play towards bot side, because to your point, they did kind of know that he was clearing up towards top and would likely come from that side, but didn't have eyes on Jarvan for a while, and Faker was actually kind of edging towards the top side of the map. So as soon as you get hit and the follow-through comes down, you're just going to die. And bad goes to worse, because he expended the Flash, they got no summoners, and you still died. Plus, the first blood went to Showmaker, and it is the tier 2 boots, bought up immediately with Predator. He did this against Mad, and then basically said it was for fun, but I do not buy it.
Nope. The one man who's not having a lot of fun is Karia here on the bottom side. These early trades, miserable right now for the Jhin and the Zillion. Of course, we get later in the game, a much stronger pick overall, but these early levels very hard. And yeah, as you highlighted, Showmaker not buying for lane in this case, buying for the tier 2 Predator boots. That much easier to find the setup. And Kanan waiting in the darkness, really clever pathing here. Faker has to be careful.
He knows there's a pink in river, so he's going to EQ over the wall, waits for his EQ, 4 seconds left on it, then he's going to flash over when Showmaker hits the stun. Maybe he can just save it here. Faker might be dead if he walks up, but there's no creeps for him to last hit, so there's no reason to walk up. He can just let the wave come into him. Nice creative try there from Kanan to avoid the vision, but we'll just go end up and clear his second respawn. Kanan has not based yet, and Owner is quite a few camps up.
And I do think this pick about the Predator a little bit, you know, it's obviously weaker for the 1v1, but if you can get the push and move towards sides, if you think that this game is going to be won by punishing sides, by punishing things like the Zillion that we talked about, by punishing things like this cannon, that it can have a lot of value. And Zillion did just base. Gumayushi is by himself here, and Showmaker is behind, and this is looking like a dead Jhin.
Rain comes down, stun gonna get flashed away from Owner is in the area. Showmaker needs to retreat back into his team. Can look for the Maokai knockback to stop the Xin Zhao engage, but they're
under
the tower. Kanan on the way in, that's gonna be it. Owner finding a kill right back. Now the flag and drag in, he's gonna finish off Owner. Gumayushi trying to get a few more kills, but can't get anything else as Damwon Kia pull out.
Yeah, Damwon have to be careful. The reason is Kana just based in front of Khan and he had TP. He's gonna use it to lane now, but I think Damwon were maybe calling that there's a TP chance opportunity there. 2 versus 4, going 1 for 1 there for T1. Small win, but Owner lost his double buffs.
Yeah, it was good for Owner though, being able to actually match this on the play. If Owner's not there, that's a free kill. That's multiple plates. Instead, he does show up just in time. The root onto Showmaker. And then Barrel has to peel for Showmaker. But that means he's going to pick up Tower Egger. He's going to go down. And it does allow them to defend in this situation. Yes, you lose the double buffs. But you got flashes, you know, off of Kanan. And you went in a pretty good spot.
Sorry, Connor was just about to level up to 6. I thought he was about to just flash in on to Khan. He was one creep away, so I thought he was just about to go for the all-in, but it looks like Khan will be the one getting pushed in.
Seen this play before. Faker on the rise, moving up to the top side. Not in this series, but of course, playoffs. Maybe gonna go for that one, but for now just threatening. As long as he has that ultimate up and available, Khan has to give him a little bit of respect here, but Khan with the calling, if Khan overcommits, does not connect on that ultimate. It can turn against him quite rapidly. That said, checking in across the board, you can see massive individual CS lead for Owner at this moment. Kanan very focused on covering for the team. It doesn't quite have that same reliable clear speed that the Zin does. See if he can do anything to catch up.
And that's the risk when you play Jarvan. This champion just clears more slowly. They're going bot here. Barrel, no flash.
Warp coming in. Barrel going to be in trouble. He's going to try to get anything done here. Nope, he's just going to get deleted. Twisted advance forward, will get knocked down. T1 control at the bottom side.
Yeah, kill over to Faker. Maybe they can translate that into a Drake, but look at Kanan. He's been hovering towards his top side. Khan has cleared out the wave for now, but he's going to have to back off because Showmaker can run top with Predator after having pushed out the wave. Kanan won't be level 6, so Khan will just back off without having to use Flash. And a small cross map coming in from Damwon.
Does always hurt because he's got no TP, so the wave is going to bounce. Then you're in that bit of a different dangerous situation. But Khan now, seeing Showmaker mid, will try to push his way back out, checks the brush with the Shuriken, but doesn't see Kanan, has no eyes on him just yet.
Yeah, and the big problem T1 again has is Showmaker has TP, just as you talked about TP's there, Azale. Showmaker can just push in mid now base, yep. And he can match up play bot if T1 overforce, or he can TP top to make sure the play happens. Kana.
Drag the flash out from Kana, has the ultimate available, waiting for a brief moment to lock it down, but Damwon Kia, easy kill pickup on the top side.
Yeah, Kana knew jungle was top side, and he flashes a little bit to the side there rather than towards his tower, so not much distance gained, and will end up falling. Now the Kennen has no TP, no flash, and is losing lane. Owner's looking for a cross map, but Showmaker has TP.
Well, how close to 6 is Karrion? If Karrion gets 6, this dive actually becomes really doable. I'm not sure that they'll actually go for it in the 3v2, knowing that Showmaker could actually TP to match, but we could see the experience. It could happen.
Spots Owner, Faker, Flash about to come off of cooldown. For now, they're just pressuring. It looks like at least one tower plate will go over as Gumushi picks that one up. Split between 3, so not the biggest gold advantage, but small positive as 4 shot with that speed buff comes out.
And it is worth noting that it's actually Karrion going for the tier 2nd here. You know, when you're not going to play Spell Thieves on the Zillion, you do need that mana regen. It is such a mana-hungry champion. Oftentimes, you can just sit on the tier, though, and then go into your support item. You don't need to actually complete that by any means, but things are going to get problematic on this top side because Canyon already got the kill, they got the flash off of Kana, and now they're going to take Herald and look to try to blow that open.
Yeah, T1 have been sieging this bot tier 1 for at least a minute and a half now, but they can't commit because Showmaker has TP, so Damwon just cross-map and get themselves a Herald. We talked about Damwon having to win the early game. They've got 3 kills on the top side of the map, one of them on Lucian, one of them on the Syndra. Early boots for Showmaker to move around the map, TP advantage, and now they've got the Herald too, so I feel like their early game towards the top side is working up pretty perfectly here. And T1 haven't really found much response on the bot side of the map.
Faker holding pressure in mid lane for now. Predator pop by Showmaker. It looks like just to get a little bit extra movement speed in some of those trades.
So Karrion is now 6, and it looks like their response is just going to be to try to take this dragon, but it will put Kana in a very heavily losing situation because he doesn't know, you know, where J4 is. They haven't seen Candy in a long time. Owner hovering here around mid, but Faker looks to be the target once more.
Faker, sidestep on the stun is big. Canyon would have followed up there. And crucially, while Owner does have a massive individual CS lead, he had not recalled yet, so didn't actually have an advantage in terms of itemization if that had come down to the 2v2.
And looks like they're just going to hand off blue buff and wait for their opportunity with Herald, as Khan now has the top pressure. We saw about 2 or 3 minutes ago, Kana was the one who was able to zone away Khan, but now without Flash, it's really hard to kind of force the Lucian back or threaten any kind of all-in when you're behind like this. And Beryl moving towards the top side. Looks like Damwon might want to just take the Grump there for Canyon and look to Herald this. Carry us there to respond, and Faker has TP up soon after he bases now.
And you have to remember, if you're going for one of these aggressive plays, Karrion has the ultimate available now, which is going to be so critical to counteract some of these upfront burst cooldowns, things like the Syndra ultimate.
Yeah, both teams are just reading each other's plays so perfectly, all their cross-mapping. So really good decisions coming out from both these teams. If Karrion didn't move towards the top side here, Damwon would have cracked open that tier 1, but because they see them there, looks like they're going to go towards mid and try to catch T1 as they rotate down towards the mid lane. Canyon getting some vision for the team.
Waiting over the wall. Faker returning to lane now. Massive wave here. He's going to miss at least a few CS. Maybe just a cannon. Even then, you'll be there in time. Damwon Kia not really feeling confident enough to go for the dive, but on the top side, they are for T1. Owner stepping forward. Wind becomes lightning will be big here. Good sidestep from Khan, though, stopping that play in its tracks. A decent amount of time committed for T1 on the top side means Damwon Kia gets primary access, or priority access, rather, to this Drake.
T1 make plays towards the top side, but Damwon can respond towards the bot side. So it feels like every play T1 are making, Damwon are just getting more, right? They threaten something bot, Damwon get a kill, and they get a Herald. Now they're threatening something top, and they just got a dragon for free. So no neutrals for T1 in this early game, and they're slowly slipping behind in the gold lead. They need to find something soon, but like you said, Azale, their scaling is pretty comfortable.
I mean, I think if you're looking at the bot lane and you knew you could get to this point with the Zillion, you're up a little bit of farm there on Gumayushi, you would be very, very happy. And Owner, he has been getting stuff done because he has been pathing very efficiently, farming more heavily. Canyon has been kind of ghosting his lanes and trying to find these plays. And if they could get a kill here on Khan, that would do a lot to get Kana back in this. And it looks like they're moving topside potentially with the Realm Warp.
Yeah, Kana fake base there, I think, and just hitting the bush. So Khan thought he could push out. And they tried to set up a trap, but Khan respects it very well and will back off. He has a Gale Force already, so a lot of the mobility on this Lucian, and he will win out on this 1v1 very, very hard the later the game goes, especially right now. He might face check Owner.
Oh, has to dash away, looking for those last few autos to find the knockup. Wind becomes lightning, will not connect. Just a decent amount of damage down onto Khan, trying to support Khanna in pushing out this lane. A lot of time spent there. Faker not quite sidestepping on that one. It's going to get locked up. The chain CC is just too much. This man cannot push a single button, but it might not matter because Karrion is bringing him back to life. And now T1 are looking for the turn. This is the power of the Zillion. Owner's on the way in. Connor ready to come over the wall. But no, the cannon not going to commit quite yet. Waiting, biding his time. Now the ulti comes out, but is it too late? Predator coming in for Showmaker. They're going to finish one kill. And now Khan is coming in looking for cleanup. Both sides backing away. the end of the day, just Khan dropping. Ulti connecting. Khan, can he sidestep? Last shot should connect. Owner going to finish the kill.
Nicely done, and Khan coming in on the TP did turn that for Damwon, but you see the power of the Zillion there. The ult used, then the exhaust used after the ult onto Showmaker, really hampering Showmaker's ability to actually burst down Faker, and it does save Faker. They get a kill back, but still, Damwon are trading back and forth, and they're going to drop the Herald here now with T1 on a reset. We'll see how quickly they can actually get out to mid to try to defend this play.
Yeah, it feels like every play is kind of going in Damwon's favor, whether it's a cross map or a match. T1, yes, you get a 1-for-1, but the Herald's going to come down. And look at this Kennen. One that Faker is ulting on them.
Canyon ready to go in. Excellent, excellent use of the stair now. Come in, Gumushi running for his life. He's ticking, he's burning. Not quite enough. He's healing up just in time. Fleet footwork taking him out to safety. Faker sped up as well. They will walk away, but more plates going down in favor of Damwon Kia and so many blinking health bars.
Man, Showmaker, the Everfrost there was so big. As Faker and Gumayushi arrive, they're both lined up. They get double Everfrost rooted, the flag and drag through two from Canyon, and that means not only do they get sums, they get the tower.
Yeah, they thought they could make a pick onto Showmaker because he has no flash, and without the Syndra ult and the Jarvan ult, maybe Faker thought they don't have enough damage to burst us down, and we can get a kill here for free for Damwon overextending. But in the end, Damwon will get the tower. Gumayushi has no summoners.
Walking forward, we'll just trade ult for ult there.
He's got Zillion.
He's
the third summoner.
That'll save him, but what will save Kana in this top lane? 20 CS down, down does level up to level 9 though, but no mythic completed. This Lucian is just going to get stronger and stronger.
I mean, for Kana, you got to hope for 5v5, right? You're not going to be winning that 1v1 at all this game until you get to maybe really late stages if he face checks you or something. We've seen those kind of plays happen, but generally it's about the 5v5 here for T1. But at this point, Damwon are extending a pretty significant gold lead. This is what's feeling like the first significant one of the game. It's closing in on that 2k margin. They do have the first dragon for themselves. Wasn't a super early Drake, so we're not obviously worried about Soul at this point, but I do think T1 are going to be wanting to start fighting around these objectives.
Yeah, that's completely right, and that's exactly what happened in game one. Damwon had an early gold lead, they got the first dragon, they set up around the second dragon, and T1 was forced to contest around the second and third dragon. That's where Damwon escalated the gold lead and snowballed the game towards Barons and closing it out. So T1 have to be very careful. If Damwon have set up, very dangerous to face check the Maokai and the Syndra. They'll have so much vision control with the saplings.
You can see again why they've gone for the Maokai, even outside of the contract with Leona. There is so much of that vision control that you highlighted. Damwon Kia now setting up for the Herald. T1, a lot of members in the area. Kana coming down does have ulti available, but have to see if T1 really want to contest for this. This is a high-risk scenario. You get a lot of value out of that Kennen ult. It's an easy fight, but a lot of potential burst damage that could come through. Carrier's ulti not quite off cooldown yet.
Kana has the Blast Cone, so he can go into the pit and he won't be spotted, so he can hide around the wall here. Damwon won't spot him just yet, so if Damwon overcommit, they know there's a Kennen. They will spot him out now, and now the Herald's reset at T1 are stacked up.
Flash in, that's going to be the Jarvan ult kicking things off, and Jin just locked in the pit, but now the ulti coming in from the MF. Bullet time looking good. Gumayushi now running for his life. Kana does everything, but Kana with the instant turn, locking down so many members. T1 just like that. That's their skirmishing power, but Showmaker still standing. Ghost, Canyon, Barrel still alive. At the end of the day, DK still holding on. It's a bloodbath, but nobody's that any closer to getting the Herald knocked down. Damwon Kia standing strong here. Owner sped up, ready to dive in if he needs to. Showmaker low mana. He's blinking. Back and forth, T1, they've lost the stare down. They will back away and concede the Herald to Damwon Kia.
Yeah, that's going to be it. Kana found a massive engage there. Ghost didn't have exhaust to shut the Kennen down, and that's what saved the fight for T1. It looked disastrous because as they pushed Damwon away, Damwon realized T1 was overstacked. They engaged with Canyon flashing forwards. Really good MF ult to follow up. But T1 have the Zillion, and T1 have the Xin Zhao ultimate to negate all the damage. So it looked bad, but it wasn't as bad when you zoom in.
But it is a nice punish because Gumayushi, they knew he had no flash because of that Realm War play mid lane. So they go in immediately for him. Maokai ultimate, J4 ultimate, MF ultimate, all coming over top. Makes it very difficult for T1 to turn. And then in comes Kana once that expires.
Yeah, Showmaker just melts straight through Kana and T1. The only real way they can contest this is if Owner hits a W, Wind becomes Lightning, and then he can dash in and maybe find a single target, because that's what T1's comp does when the Kennen dies.
But you can see the Damwon maybe have to respect the Kennen as we get later in the game. The only reason that really worked out so well for them is because the Kennen is behind. He is not wildly far ahead. That ult could have killed. If they're in late game and Khan leaps in like that, it will cost him his life every single time.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Ghost, though, didn't have his exhaust for that fight, as Kajal pointed out. Owner, oh, you looking dead.
Locked down.
Carrier's coming.
Walking in, healing, holding on for now. Carrier coming in over the wall, has used the ultimate. They have to wait this one out. The lock up there, the TP in from Faker. They've taken down Barrel. The revive coming through just in time.
Man, Carrier has been so clutch with these revives, getting so much value already in this game. And I do think that Zillion is a little bit of a ticking time bomb. It's very difficult to deal with this. I mean, Dom1 have been playing out the zone control so well, utilizing the Maokai, utilizing the J4 and the MF. But the longer the game goes, the shorter those cooldowns get for Zillion, and the tougher it is to actually punch through.
What is it with Ten's T1 series and support picks? MF Syra, now things like Zillion and Maokai coming through, saving the day, and T1 adapting so well with the pick. We'll see if they can net them this win here, because
that's a fast Zhao.
Canyon has no flash. Owners doesn't either.
Forced to EQ out to safety, looking for the collapse. Can't afford to overextend here, but all of T1 ready to collapse. Jim with the ultimate coming in as well, and T1. They can get started, they can scale up in these fights. The Kennen's so powerful. We may see a similar situation to last game where it comes down to a very tense Baron take and a single AoE ult really deciding the game.
Yeah, it feels like Zillion's just slowing the pace of the game down. It's just slowing down the kills for Damwon to snowball the game. It's almost like the ship is slowly sinking, but you're just patching the holes with the Zillion ult. So T1, yes, you're stopping these kills from happening, and you're kind of trading one for one, but you're going down in the trades. The only good news for them is their scaling is good. The problem is Damwon have two dragons, Cloud Soul once again, similar to game one, and they still have control of the map.
I also really like the build adaptation here from Beryl. The first time he actually played, as we'll see if Faker can get away, everyone going towards stops. The first time he played this, he went Deadman's as his first item. This time it is actually going to be more about the poke. It's going to be more about utilizing space and staying away from T1, keeping them at arm's length. So instead, he swaps up the item build here. I think it's really, really intelligent.
Oh yeah, definitely. And you just look at the map state, similar to every single game so far. Cross maps coming in, instant response from both teams. Beautiful League of Legends coming out, trades-offs of the Tier 1 once again. And both these teams have just been reading the map so well, whether to match plays or to cross map and trade. T1 have to push in mid though, so they kind of have two lanes to play on, and they can start hitting this mid Tier 1. But Khan has TP, and so does Showmaker, who's basing right now.
And again, I think the Zillion can't be highlighted enough. Gumayushi playing so far forward, Damwon, Kia. Lots of members in that area. Maybe felt like they could go for a pick, but Carry is waiting right over the wall, hovering between mid and bot, ready to come in with that ultimate and deny that kill from coming through. This is such a nuisance for Damwon to deal with.
It's such a frustrating pick because it really does change the way you play. You know, with these kind of styles of compositions that Damwon is running, it's generally just kind of like overwhelming force that you want to throw on one member, insta-kill them, and then play out the fight from a 5v4 state. Zillion says you can't do that. So you have to really kind of spread out your cooldowns. You can't fully commit everything. If you throw J4 ult, MF ult, Showmaker's ult, everything on one person to try to kill them, they get Zillion ulted, you're going to lose the extended play. So they've got to be really smart about how they're spending their damage.
Yeah, of course, Zillion really good into burst mages like Syndra. The only things that Zillion struggles against is high DPS, like things like Azir, or massive wombo combos where he's got way too many targets to juggle and ultimate. So if Damwon can find a really good engage with the Maokai Jarvan MF combo, just like he talks about, then the Zillion ult will be negated. And if Lucian gets the 4 or 5 items and can free hit in fights, then the Zillion will struggle. But as Damwon keep committing to this single target, Carrier just sit comfortably and press one button.
And in these extended games, the Zillion passive, the experience that you can actually funnel into these members can become quite valuable. You know, Gumayushi is up a little bit on experience in Khan.
That's the ultimate coming out. A little bit sloppy from Khan. He does have the flash almost off of cooldown. Carrier coming in over the wall. Khan could be in trouble. The flash forward. Showmaker now been locked up.
He's got no flash.
The root going in. Khan, no ultimate though. Will get burned down. Showmaker going golden, but they should be able to finish up the kill here. That's the root. That's the lockup. Damwon Kia backing away. It's a 1-for-1. Top for mid.
Khan getting a little bit excited there when he sees Showmaker with no flash and locked up from Faker. He commits his flash as well and ends up trading a 1-for-1. He has TP in a minute's time for when this dragon spawns, and T1 have some control of the bot side of the map.
That to me felt like nerves. You don't need to actually commit your flash there. You can wait for the Zillion to come through. They're trying to hunt for Ghost. We'll see if they can find him, but yeah, could have played it slowly, waited for Carry to have the ulti there to save you, and spending your flash as Kennen is so expensive.
Ghost in no man's land. The Baron being used against him. Canyon in the area. Owner is going to cost too much. Baker off to the backside doing so much damage. But Canyon there as well. TP now coming in. Barrel running for his life. Baker ticking, blinking, but that health bar doesn't hit zero. He will not come back. Khan trying to time it, but gets it just a little bit off. Khan waiting up to the side, but he has no ultimate. Gumayushi, Gale Force forward to find the kill. T1 prior access to the Baron or the Drake. Their
Khan TP behind him.
But they want a little bit more action. Khan stepping forward. Predator coming in from Showmaker. He's zooming forward. If he hits Gumayushi with the full combo, he's going to be in trouble. There's no ultimate there to stop him. But Khan getting locked up. Khan, can he make it out of this one? The snare is there. Khan finishes the fight. T1 taking absolute control in these skirmishes. And now Showmaker, he's going to be in trouble. The knockback comes in. It's clutch. Owner running for the hills. But T1 getting everything they want.
Yeah, they pushed Damwon back and they herd them like sheep. They chased him down and get all of their summoners almost, other than Canyon. They won't be able to translate into a Baron. But such good mechanical plays coming in from each individual from both sides to keep this fight so prolonged.
Absolutely. But I think you can see a little bit of nerves there. there too. The play from Khan on the bot side, Khan going early on the Zillion ult. That's a 450 gold shutdown that you could have had on Faker, but he didn't wait out the ultimate, and instead Faker survives. Dom1 have to run tails between their legs here, as it's just a great one warp to start it up in the Axe Effect replay.
Yeah, they spot out Ghost. Carrier does manage to see him. This all comes from just a Dragon contest and setup. Ghost is isolated, and Carrier just pops the bomb onto the Baron, right? So Ghost is tanking it. He has to get out of the pit. Owner saves his E for when Ghost flashes away. And then, like you talked about, Azale, the ult comes out onto Faker, and Canyon leaves him on 1 HP thinking, okay, we'll let it reset. Damage comes in from the sapling, and it procs the ultimate.
Oh, I thought it was the Khan W. It was the sapling there.
Yeah, Khan was around the back. Khan tries to dodge away, but in the end, T1 was able to chase him down.
Yeah, that is huge, being able to actually get the reset, to be able to get that revive, not go down, not lose that bounty. T1 now in a gold lead here. And this Zillion, I just think, is taking over the game. It feels like it has been so critical. The move speed, the revives, the Guardian plus Exhaust to actually stop a lot of what Dom1 is trying to do as far as their burst goes.
Absolutely. And I think when you look at the side for T1, when you've got a Zillion sitting back reviving these members, Dom1 feel like the team that has to step forward, that has to shut this pick down. But if you walk forward into the cannon, you're making Khan's life so easy. Execution going to be name of the game here. Is Gumayushi doing his best the fast impression? Just zooming around with that Zillion speed up.
And T1 got the Cloud Dragon. So Dom1 aren't on three dragons. They have the Cloud Dragon. They'll slow down the Soul Point.
Yeah.
And they're just trying to contest this mid push nonstop. Faker doesn't want to go on a side lane. Khan doesn't want to go on a side lane against Khan and Showmaker with Predator. They don't want to get picked off one by one. You were talking about it, Azale. That was one of the big problems T1 had, was side lanes. They would get caught out a lot. It looks like in this series, they're just grouping up mid, brute forcing down mid for tier ones. Khan sitting on a flank, just ignoring bot waves.
Yeah, I think he's looking to see if someone was going to come face check there, because he does have the damage to actually burst down someone like Khan. But he's also hesitant to show bot because he has no TP. So he's showing bot now, and Dom1 will look to make a play top.
Ooh. CC just barely not connecting. Faker making it out.
Not even close. All timed out.
Playing with fire there a little bit. As we talk about getting caught out on sides, Faker almost dies. Khanna is pushing bot with no TP, and we know what Damwon's like around this Baron, especially against Mad Lions in that series. They weren't afraid to just start up a Baron and force a fight if you misstep on the map. Khanna being bot with no TP, making sure it's a 5v4.
I mean, if Faker gets caught there, Dom1 start Baron, because Khanna's bot, no TP, Faker's dead. That would be a massive play, but Faker just barely able to get out here. And this is getting really, really exciting. This next fight is feeling like there's going to be fireworks. Zillion with Cloud Soul, by the way, is like comical levels of fast, where your whole team with a passive move speed. Plus, if Shirelia's. T1 get towards Soul, you have Shirelia's, you'd have four Cloud Souls, so you basically don't have a cooldown in your ultimate anymore at that point.
It's bad news when the Syndra has Predator and she's zooming as fast as she can and the Zin's just running past you. You know, that's not the look that you want here.
They have more horsepower.
I mean, they're not even running. You got Usain Bolt, but he's in a Ferrari, so.
But I think the big thing for Damwon was holding the early to mid game together was Khan was winning over side lane. The Lucian was ahead. Yeah. We saw three kills towards the top side. But now Khan is down a level onto Khanna, and TP's coming up as well. So the side lane pressure we expected Damwon to have is not there. The only thing they have is control. But T1's raw team fighting is better with things like the Kennen and the Zillion ult, as we talked about. But Damwon still have got good pick potential, and they have got good wombo combo if it comes together.
And look how high level Gumayushi is at this point. Kiri has been putting all his experience into this Jhin. He's higher level than the solo laner as well. Showmaker just hit 14, but he's two levels up on Khan on this Lucian.
And I think the reality is it's so hard to get into the back line to even hit Gumayushi without that Jarvan ultimate. You can see Dom1 Kia posturing like they want to get something done. Predator popped by Showmaker. T1 playing with a lot of respect here. Faker on the bottom side. They know they can't fully commit for anything.
I also really like going for the rapid fire third here in this case on Jhin, because you can get the Zillion speed up, you move in, you get this one long range shot. If that's a crit, that poke starts to become pretty impactful.
Definitely does. And Faker is pushing out bot now. Looks like he will be the side laner for T1. He's the one with TP to join up towards the Baron pit. And they really want to crack open this mid tower, T1, so they can start pushing into Damwon's top side on the top side of the map to push them out and get some vision lines to start up Baron and look for turns with things like the Kennen.
And we know those Kennen flanks are so incredibly crucial to finding winning teamfights. You saw Khanna hovering in Fog of War with no mid lane tower down. It gets so much easier once they are able to break that. But for now, Dom1 Kia doing an excellent job of holding the line. Sadly, hard for them to play super proactively. Again, level 11 Zillion, relatively low cooldown on that ultimate. But they're going to need to fight for these Drakes. They're going to need to fight for the Baron if it comes to that. Canyon stepping forward here. Khanna going to find the lockup in just a little bit of poke. But Risky face check just to secure a little bit of priority around this objective.
You talked about scaling Azale in T1's favor. Faker on Ryze, level 15 and 3 items. That's a scary opponent to be against. Ryze is one thing in the late game, but Faker on Ryze is another in a Worlds semifinal in Game 3, which can set the momentum for the rest of the series. T1 starting to cast midwaves as 5. TP coming in from Showmaker to match. Everyone wants to stop each other getting into River, but T1 have access first. 20 seconds on the Dragon. Gumayushi has so much speed to work with.
Rapid fire, fourth shot, goes in for the poke. They're gonna try to look at rinse and repeat. And T1 have the luxury items here. They got stopwatch on top, on jungle, nothing on the side for Dom1. They have the three items complete, both mid and bot. The three just complete for Showmaker.
Carry up.
And Carry now stepping forward, looking for the double bomb. Carry locked up. Where's the ultimate gonna go? But for now, Gumayushi untouched. Owner immediately into the back line, buying as much time as possible, but it's two quick kills for T1. And here come the curtain call. It's like a rinse and repeat of game two. But in the back side, Showmaker finds one, tries to find the snare, tries to find
Faker.
The lock, but Faker turning it back. Faker finding one kill, gonna look for a little bit more. That's a three item Ryze. Ghost running for the hill, and T1 with confidence taking the fight.
I never thought I'd say this, Dracos, but Carrier just engaged on Zilean. The Jin W hit onto Showmaker, and Carrier flashes forwards with the double bomb to find the engage. Four kills for one for T1. Faker with the Ryze ult, insanely good follow up for Kana, but he gets one shot before he can use his ultimate. But T1 will get the Baron.
T1 onto the Baron, the next evolution of support here at Worlds. We've seen the Maokai, but it is all about the Zilean. Carrier is destroying Dom1. They just don't really know how to play out these fights. They see these people piling in. They don't want to overcommit too much damage. But then if you're not putting enough damage in onto Owner, well, then you can't even finish anyone off. And T1 even get the luxury of waiting for the respawn there for Kana to get 5 Baron buffs. Let's see it one more time.
Look at this. Gumayushi walks up, hits the W, and Carrier is engaging on Zilean with a double bomb. And then it's ready to react in time to make sure his team is safe. Canyon goes in to negate the engage, but doesn't have enough damage follow-up, so Gumayushi, he just sits in the pit all alone.
Obviously, fantastic fight coming through. Love the finish here. Realm Warp across. You can see T1 playing with absolute confidence. Again, rookie lineup showing up like this against a team who so thoroughly thrashed them domestically. Putting up this level of performance in Game 3. Fantastic to watch. Of course, don't forget to grab your exclusive Oh My Days.
Ghost is dead! Gumayushi has killed Ghost. 50 seconds on Ghost. They have the mid push, they have Baron buff. Barrel has to use the ultimate to buy time. Owner is on the side.
Yeah, they're looking to try to end here. Owner wants the flank. They're TPing in.
Flashing away, pulling back. All of T1 collapsing. They've got the Baron, they've got everything they need in their hands. Kana with flash up and available, a stopwatch as well. Carrier with ultimate. They've got all the tools they need to finish this game. Dom1 Kia have to weather the storm, but it's feeling harder and harder.
Level 16 Jin. Gumayushi has so much movement speed to work with. T1 are on the cusp of giving Dom1 two back-to-back defeats. Even though they came into this series undefeated at Worlds 2021, the siege is coming in from T1. They have Faker's ultimate available. Kana has flash, like you said, Dom1 have to be very careful.
No way. T1 do not want to risk anything. They do not want to give anything away. Dom1 Kia, how many times did they pull the rabbit out of the hat, found a miracle situation, and found a way back into the game? They did it time and time again against T1 in that finals. Dom1, T1 in the driver's seat and looking to close this one out.
Yeah, we can see this again, how Ghost went down, and it's the trap into the W there. Catches him out and just bursts him down. I mean, look how fast he is! That's not a human being, that's a car! He just completed the IE on base as well. Ghost is in trouble here because Gumayushi is massive.
Yeah, now T1 still have a little bit of Baron buff to work with. 1 minute left. They got the top tier 2. They got the top tier 3. Now they're looking at the bot tier 2. A lot of standing gold for them on the map, and they want to push this forwards. This Jin is unstoppable. He has both summoners up very shortly, and he has so much movement speed to work with. Dom1 only really have skill shots to lock him down, and he can still flash out of the Jarvan ultimate. Worst case, if you try to burst him down, he has a Zilean ult right behind him. Gumayushi has every single tool he needs to help T1 win this game.
Gumayushi said he believed that they were the best bot lane in the tournament. This performance between the Zilean and the Jin certainly looking like it might be the case. Absolute dominance here. Now it all comes down to the footwork. He's got the movement speed. As long as he doesn't get hit, Team 1, or rather DK, don't feel like they have any answers to this champion.
It's so difficult as long as Carrier is playing far behind the Jin. I mean, he's on 4 items. Ghost only has 2 completed. Every time the rapid fire is ready, you get sped up, you walk forward. If you can get one auto on any of these squishies, it is dangerous. And T1 are pushing on all sides. Kana, with that speed up, he's trying to threaten as well.
But one mistake from Gumayushi, one overstep, one Syndra stun hitting him, could affect T1's teamfight. If he gets locked down and the Zillion ult has to be used very early, it's dangerous.
Drag locking up three. That's going to be the MF ult across the entire team. It's massive. The revive now coming through. Owner in the midst of everybody. The Gore Drinker is still doing massive, massive work. Showmaker goes golden, tries to buy a bit more time. Kumayushi, Faker, Karia, can they do it? It's a 4v3, but they're confident to try to turn it. Faker moving forward, but he can't get the damage down. Khan still
Kumayushi!
Standing. Kumayushi, flash it. Kumayushi, four shot. Wants to finish the job. Kumayushi can't even win the fight. It's Khan on the backside looking to finish off Faker, but the lockup from downtown will not connect. Captive audience not going to find a home. Now the Realm Warp coming in, trying to take them out to safety. It's a neck and neck fight. Kumayushi will not find the curtain call, and Damwon Kia will live to fight another day.
A great engage there from Damwon. That's what they needed, threatening multiple members. So Karia couldn't get a high value ultimate. Kana actually went down, and Karia only got the self-ulti, which is really not what you're looking for as the support Zillion. It's about bringing up these tough-to-kill carries, so you have to take them down twice. And in this case, Damwon hold on with a brilliant engage.
Yeah, Damwon knew they had to pull the trigger. Canyon does find it. Owner buys a lot of time in the backline, and he's going to buy even more now that he's got a Guardian Angel. The good thing for Damwon, though, is Kumayushi has no flash, so now when he does this again, he will die, but they will have the Zillion ult to back him up. But you can see the damage Kumayushi does in these fights as he flashes away. The turn he has, so much damage to push Damwon back.
And one of the biggest problems is that Karia gets caught in there with him. The Zillion must be far enough backwards. You see Kana goes down, he has to self-ult there. Karia missed positioning, and Canyon immediately punished.
Yeah, Kana flashed into the jar of an ultimate wall there, so he couldn't get over, and then it turns into this 3v4 stare down where Faker wants to force it. Kumayushi gets the kill onto Ghost, but then Khan, stopwatch comes out from Faker, and then he does land the root, runs away, pops the ultimate, and brings T1 to safety.
Such a tense game. It felt like the edge of victory there for T1. If they played that one out perfectly, game was absolutely in their hands. Karia getting caught. Canyon seeing his moment, seeing his opportunity. 23 seconds left to the soul. Damwon Kia can get that. Maybe that is their way back into the game. But for now, T1 taking control of the Dragon Pit, taking control of the area. Damwon Kia are going to have to fight their way back in if they want to contest that Drake.
And now Karia has Zhonya, so he has an ability to actually keep himself safe and still save that ultimate for a teammate. And Zillion scaling is just so insane from the support position. You do not need gold, you just need the levels at this point. And T1 are going to be able to grab this dragon for free.
Faker is level 18 on this rise, highest level in the game. Kumayushi, level 17. Look at Damwon. Khan is level 15. If Faker lands any combo on him, he's dead. If Kumayushi gets two auto attacks, he is dead. T1 own the map right now. Damwon have to pick and choose their fights very, very carefully if they want to win this game.
Kumayushi now five items. He's 100% crit at this point. That is so terrifying with what is a largely really squishy team that Damwon are running.
Yeah, and Damwon Kia, range certainly not in their favor outside of Showmaker's ability to cast Scout of the Week, but with how fast this Jhin is, it feels nigh impossible to land. If it's a slow, extended siege, these rapid-fire cannon auto attacks are going to cut through the health bars of Khan, of Ghost, of Showmaker.
Owner
stepping forward. All of Damwon Kia retreating now as Kumayushi is a very fast boy. Again, not a man, but a car.
And T1, they can push them in mid so far and then use the Realm Warp to take all of T1 to
go. Drag lock up onto Faker. He's going to flash up to safety. Canyon now has to retreat, but it's going to cost him his life just for stepping
Owner on the
forward.
Side.
Owner on the flank. Canyon locked up for now. Here comes the curtain call and TP into the mid lane. Canyon trying to flag Dragon's way out, but Kumayushi spots it and calls him on it as T1 now advances on the mid lane. Kana! He's gonna get resurrected, but that's the ulti down. What is he doing? He stepped forward, and now he has to go golden. Perfect ult off to the side from Ghost. Owner now getting taken down as well. That's the GA coming out for Owner. Lock up there. Showmaker now has to back
Kumayushi.
Off. But Kumayushi is just too damn fast. He's godlike now as T1 move in and look for the end.
You can run, you can hide, but Kumayushi is coming for you, Damwon.
Looks like they're going to go for the top in if they have the Realm Warp, if they want to go towards the Baron. Showmaker will go back to base and get his mana back up. T1 don't have a wave to push further in, and Kana is very low. It looks like they won't be able to end the game, but two in hips, and here's the Realm Warp straight to Baron. They're going to pick that one up. T1 look very disjointed in these fights. Kana going in when they've already got a pick, and then Kumayushi has to go back to pop the ultimate. Karia has to use the ult to save Kana. A lot of things were very messy there, losing GA on Owner 2. So, Damwon still lose the fight. They lose Baron, and T1. They're gonna come for that bot in him.
12k gold lead. Anything less than flawless execution on the side of Damwon Kia in the next fight means the game will end like that.
And this is where you can see that lack of experience from some of the T1 players. I think that's nerves to me when you see Kana going in so far ahead of the team. You know, they're going for this initial play. Kana arrives, gets the speed up, and it felt like he just decided he was going for it as Gumayushi sniping down Canyon. And this is where you're just going too far forward, right? He gets stunned up. They have to blow the Zillion ultimate immediately. Then he's into the Zonias, but he's going to die either way. Owner even loses the GA off of that, and it just really feels like nerves to me.
Definitely overall a very messy fight when you see it back, and that's the thing about the Jhin as well, is that if you make mistakes, if you misposition at all, that movement speed makes it so easy now for him to punish. But that said, Kana, the one who needs to clean it up coming into this final fight, he has the flash, he has the ultimate, there is no exhaust for Ghost. This is his time to shine. He might not even need to if T1 can keep up a nice slow siege, as highlighted earlier. One very fast Jhin with Force Shot can walk in and out and just take half your health like that.
Yeah, Gumayushi doesn't have the curtain call, but he has so much move speed still. He can just keep walking forward through the rapid fires and poking Damwon back. This third inhibitor is going to fall. T1 have three inhibs down now against Damwon. Backs against the wall. They're pushed into their nexus, Gumayushi.
Big damage, zoning them all away. Ghost has to go back to the fountain to heal up. Baron and Power Cannon minions now raining down on these Nexus towers. But Damwon Ki is still stepping forward, still ready. They know this is going to be their final fight. Gumayushi playing with absolutely no fear, but if he gets caught, if he gets hit by anything, he could get taken down. Barrel trying to zone, trying to find an opportunity. Owner, ulti now comes out. He heals so much. The power of the Gore Drinker. Ulti coming from Math doesn't do anything in the face of the Xin Zhao ultimate. And now Kana leaping in. He smells blood in the water. That's the double kill. That will be match point for T1 against Damwon Ki.
Kana made no mistake about that one, finding the ulti on multiple members. T1 eviscerate Damwon in their base. They move to match point. And again, off of these brilliant picks, the Zillion, to me, was really the story of this game. It created so many problems for Damwon. They just didn't have the answers. They didn't have enough DPS to actually play these fights slowly with Owner, with Kana flying in on you, unless they were committing all their damage to one target. And as soon as they committed all the damage to one target, well, Zillion's there to ult you right back up. They just didn't have an answer.
And gentlemen, Damwon have won every single best of five they've been in if they won the first game of the best of five. Now they're down match point against T1. Who'd have thought? People said Damwon was going to 3-0 them, but T1's flexibility in these drafts, Vedia said it on the desk, draft is so important in this series, and T1 are adapting fantastically.
Absolutely. And this is already more games than Damwon has lost in the LCK across their last three championship runs. They were 15-1. They had only lost one game in the LCK, including that BO5 against T1. They're the only people to take one off. Now they already beat them twice.
Incredible from Faker and the rookies of T1. Of course, we're going to take a closer look at T1's win in just a few minutes as they move on to match point in today's semifinal.
Hey, I didn't order any pizza.
Jake from State Farm. After you saved me so much dough on insurance with that Parker promo, I devised a promo for you.
Here's the deal, Parker. State Farm offers everyone surprisingly great rates.
Yeah, right. Pepperoni pockets, an atomic brownie, cuckoo crusty.
There's no promo, it's just great rates.
And a cider ranch. You're the man, man.
When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Gonna let me in into your castle.
Welcome back to the State Farm Analyst Desk, where I bet you didn't think we'd be in this position with T1 up 2-1.
What are you talking about? I predicted 3-2,
baby. You didn't call the 3-2. All right, fair enough, Kobe. Fair enough. You didn't call the 3-2 prediction for Damwon, but for many, I think we are in a position that we didn't expect to be. And it, in a lot of ways, has come off of some really interesting drafting, by both teams. But for T1 today, they've brought out something special.
I'm so glad that we are in this position because the especially support innovation that we've seen here. You know, first one upping with the Maokai when you have so many face checkers and slow movers and allowing you to go super all in on the pick. But now the answer, the Zilean, so much scaling, and it's combined with these hard engage options, the Xin Zhao, the Kennen. They want the full engages, so you have the extra speed for your damage threat for the Jhin, but you also have the hard commitment for the ultimate to revive your front line.
Chronicler, how did this whole series become about the supports?
Well, that's a good question you asked there. I think that the cool thing to me is that for Damwon, these R5 support counterpicks or late support counterpicks have been something that they've been doing for a while. They were also one of the teams that used the Senna meta really well, being able to make use of Barrel's Champion Pool. But for T1, I think they never leaned into it as much as we from the LCK would have liked, because Carrier is insane. Like, the man is mechanically so gifted, and seeing them actually dip into it and use the versatility that he has, I think is one of the big reasons why T1 look so much better, because we need to, like, really... We can't overstate how big this is. Like, being up 2-1 against Damwon, who've basically free out every domestic final for like the last year and a half.
I mean, yeah, it's wild to think about. You see it on your screens right there. 10 unique champions for Barrel, 8 for Carrier over the course of this tournament. Barrel, that's the most of any support in the tournament. We couldn't even fit them all up here, because you'll notice, of course, that Bazillion is missing the Yuumi, which both of them have played as well. We just edited that out because, hey, everybody's been playing that champion. But again, all of this innovation, and particularly from the side of T1, has netted them, you know, plays like this, what we'll see right here.
Yeah, this one here gonna start out with the pick from Damwon, but again, Faker is able to revive with Carrier's ultimate, and so they end up going 1-for-1 in that play. This one was huge, because that totally would have been super too deep invade promoter, but guess what? Carrier can flash over, get within range, and then I also wanted to, with all the spotlight on the support players, still highlight Faker. Because with all the attention with the young players and the Zoomers on this team, Faker did so much with his rise. It wasn't just the Zilean speed up that happened. The Realm Warts to pick off Ghosts and to section off multiple of these plays coming from Faker himself on one of his most iconic picks was also enormous. And then you even see T1 afforded the capability of making some hesitation and making some mistakes in some of the plays and still being able to steamroll. Zilean revive, plus the extra speed up coming through. Jhin equipped with that, plus all the experience and full crit, was a massive threat.
I honestly didn't expect Faker and 4 Zoomers to be taken literally, but this game, it really was. Right? Because the amount of speed and versatility that they were able to find was incredible. And there's a lot of highlight plays, but I think the main thing that T1 has been criticized for throughout the year, outside of sometimes their mid-game macro that can feel a little bit too sharp, which we saw, you know, some small individual mistakes, but they haven't really been suffering from ever since they got out of groups. The key thing to me is that they have stopped hamstringing themselves in draft consistently, and that is something that they used to really tunnel on. If you go back to like the last 2 weeks of summer, and they've just completely stopped doing that. They're actually using the depth that their players have available, and the team just looks so much scarier for it.
I like it. It was Faker and 4 Zoomers. We found the answer with a Zilean on the squad. Now it's just 5 Zoomers.
And I want to highlight, too, because it's so good specifically also against Maokai. You know, speed counters so much of what he does. The ult is extremely slow moving. Mm-hmm. With the extra speed, too, you can face check. You can go towards the brushes with the saplings. You can just outrun them. You don't take any of the damage. And I fully expect, though, Damwon to have a rebuttal here and us going to 5 games.
All right, well, we'll talk about that in just a moment, because as we have been lauding this Zilean pick, as we know, every second counts. And thanks to the reliable Cisco network, Carrier speedruns T1 to a win in a key fight under the mid lane turret. We're going to start it off with the Zilean engage of all things, the double bomb after the flash. But
but then utilizing the ultimate to keep his jungler alive as he dives well under turret range. You also called out the Realm Warps by Faker. Well, it almost went bad. It almost went bad here with the ultimate going the way of Khan in the top lane, means that Faker can close it out here.
Yeah, Showmaker has been so on point too with a lot of these mechanical outplays. You'll see he's had pinpoint accuracy with the Everfrost. He's doing so much trying to get these stuns, and yet they're still overwhelmed with the onslaught from T1.
Well, I want to go to Chronicler for our final point here, because as we go to series point, again, Shu on the other foot, it's Damwon who needs to string two together. Kobe thinks they've got a rebuttal. They've got a response to that. Zilean, what will it be?
Well, I don't know what it will be exactly. I'm just hoping to see a swap from Damwon in terms of playstyle. I think that what we saw in that third game was, for the first time in what feels like a really long time, Damwon was actually getting consistently out-skirmished and out-fought around the map. You could see that as well on the topside fight, where Khan came in rather late, where they, you know, the whole ghost being chased, taking down, and then Damwon still opting into those fights. I think if they play out that game cleaner, that there are more possibilities for them. But still, I just want more games. I don't want this series to end, because I think in terms of like individual performances, it's been, to me, the best series at World so far. Like, it's insane.
I want that too, and it can only get better if we go to five games. It's T1, who's one game away from booking a trip to the finals. First time they'd go there since 2017. It's been one hell of a series so far, and as we go to break, let's listen in on Damwon Kia's comms from the quarterfinal versus Mad Lions in Sounds of the Game, presented by Bose.
천천히